Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mario Valentin Santiago. I have been an oxygen dependent and living with COPD for the past 7 years. Thank you for coming together. This event is so important to individuals such as myself, living with COPD, to have all of these resources in one room to empowering and inspirational. I would like to thank the Help Rough Haven Collaborative COPD Chairman, Yvonne Gamblin from All About You, Home Care, and State of Connecticut Captain for COPD Foundation, and Sheila Ekeron from Qualadyn Lung Talk. I acknowledge and thank Alan Hollenock, the Director of West Haven Chamber of Commerce. Thank you to Kristen Willer from the COPD Foundation. Many thanks to Julie Reed from Qualadyn for developing the brochures, and to Don Shapiro for All About You coordinating this event. Let's go back a few years ago when I was a young, cute, and attractive boy living with asthma. As I became older, my asthma attack had slowly disappeared. In high school, I was on the volleyball and tennis team. I always carry my rescue inhaler in my socks just in case I need it. I also played tennis for 3 years for the USTA, United States Tennis Association, the Southern Connecticut League. For 16 years, I worked as a flight attendant for TWA, Transworld Airlines, American Airlines, and American Eagle. It was a very exciting and fun job. I flew all over the world and saw many different cities and meet interesting people. I always carried the rescue inhaler in my sock just in case I needed them. December 18, 2010 was like any other day. I woke up, got dressed, and drove to the airport. I was scheduled to do 3 legs that day. On the second leg, I was a little winded. I used my rescue inhaler and felt okay. It was my asthma, I thought. I used my inhaler many, many times before, so why would I think anything different? It was time to board for the third and final leg of the evening. In the middle of the flight, I was getting winded again, and I used my inhaler a few more times. I felt tired and sleepy. I just wanted the flight to be over. I was ready to go grab the crew bus to the hotel room and go to sleep. Finally, we landed. I was desperately trying to hang on until the last passenger left the airplane. I quickly grabbed my crew bag. I tried to walk out of the plane onto the jet bridge. Oh my God, my whole body froze. I could not move. My head suddenly felt like I was going to explode. My nails, my lips turned black. I felt like someone or something was squeezing my back. I felt like my insides were tight and being pushed together. The captain called for help. Airport security, police, and medical personnel came quickly. I was then wheeled down the jet bridge. To make a long story short, I was rushed to a hospital in Minneapolis. I arrived with an ABG of 46%. I was told hours later after CT scans, x-rays, and blood work that my body was going into a survival mode. I was diagnosed with pneumonia and hypoxia. I was so weak and sick that if I tried to sit up in bed, my oxygen would drop into a low 80s. While I was on 6 liters of oxygen. I was released 8 days later. I did not know that in December 2010, my life was going to take a dramatic turn. I now use oxygen 24/7. A few weeks later, I saw my pulmonary doctor for a follow-up. I was told I needed to be on oxygen for 6 months to a year. He referred me to the Yale New Haven Lung Life Rehabilitation Program. Oh my God, what the heck am I going to do now? I told myself I don't want oxygen. I don't need oxygen. I am not going to let my friends see me with a tube up my nose. There is nothing attractive in having a tube up your nose and across your face. I have never heard of anyone giving a compliment to another person with oxygen in their nose. I didn't want to use or be seen with oxygen. I stayed home all day and would not go out. I would wait until the nightfall so I could go to gas station, grocery stores. I would drive two towns over where no one would know me. Although I was very skeptical, I started the Lung Light Rehab Program. I can close my eyes and go back to my first couple of weeks at Lung Light 6 years ago. I was in denial that I needed to be on oxygen. I felt that it was going to be a waste of time. I was angry at life and frustrated with myself. I remember when I went home one day thinking it was going to leave, thinking I was going to leave Lung Life. I called my sister Norma and I told her that I was not happy. I told her that I'm angry at life. I missed my job. I should have died that day. I was getting depressed. I hate my life. I didn't want to live that way. She told me to stop thinking like that and thinking and saying those negative words and thoughts. She told me that she loves me and that life will get better. She told me to think about Mom, Michael, and the rest of the family that loves me. They all have and will always be there for me. You need to go back and give that program a chance. What the heck do I have to lose? I went back the next week with a different attitude. I listened and did everything Debbie and Becky told me to do. I started to use my oxygen with the exercise and started to slowly feel good about myself. I was able to do all the exercise without getting winded. I kept my oxygen level above 95, 96. After the 9 weeks, I was so happy that I finished the program. Sadly, I did what so many of us, of you guys do, and don't continue to work out. I had to come back 2 years later to the Lung Light Rehab Program to start all over again to refresh my memory on those wonderful and educational lectures and to retone my body. I already knew that the program worked. The second time around, I did not waste my time. I was determined to give it my all. At each lesson that Debbie and now with Heather, I would listen to them and absorb everything. At Lung Light, I learned the correct way to breathe using first-lip breathing through my nose and out through my mouth using my diaphragm. These breathing exercises helped me many times when I feel winded. They helped me to quickly calm myself down. Recently, we were at the Trumbull Mall and I ran out of oxygen. I was able to walk to my car and get home safely using every survival skill and technique I learned from Lung Life. Lung Life had taught me the correct way to clear my airways by huff coughing without hurting my lungs. These techniques made it easier to clear my airways so I can breathe better. Lung Light helped me to understand how important it is to know now to properly and optimally use your daily medication and treatments. I have been able to develop a medical regimen and improve my condition. As a result of my involvement with Lung Light, I have the tools, knowledge, and confidence to remain focused on all of my routines and must-have and must-do of every day. Being at Lung Life has given me the confidence to exercise, breathe, and listen to my body on different types of machines. My training at Lung Life has given me the skills to listen, know the feedbacks coming from my body. This feedback allows me to exercise and take care of myself without harming my lungs while straightening my body. This is like learning how to drive a standard car. You need to be focused and aware on when to shift from gas to pedal to crush while shifting all at once. This allows you to shift gears without stalling the car and driving the car forward. At Lung Life, you get to meet other people with COPD and other lung conditions. You get to talk and share stories of what works and what don't work. By the end of 9 weeks, some of us had bonded through our conditions. That special love is what connects us and is where lungs let us now get stronger was born. The bottom line is that I truly believe I'm here today mentally and physically strong because of Lung Life. Lung Life helped me to understand how to deal with my lung condition in a more positive way. I learned how to keep myself healthier with diet and daily exercise. I learned how to cope with all of my daily living routines. Lung Life gave and gives me hope and strength to live my new life with oxygen. I have the tools and the knowledge to allow me to breathe and relax whenever I'm in stress and feel shortness of breath or anxious. I now know the right way and safe way to remain calm and focused. I never knew that I was going to meet at Lung Life three of the nicest, strongest, and positive women who really care for my health and everyone else who comes in contact with them. They are my three angels, Debbie, Becky, and Heather. You keep going, I'll drink. The Yale Lung Life Rehabilitation Program have given me the tools, knowledge, and confidence to live life with oxygen to the fullest. I now know how to successfully understand and manage my underlying health condition. I understand the importance of my daily medications. I can stop worrying and start living. I now challenge life each day by going out of my comfort zone. I travel and see the world. I know that living with oxygen is not the end. It's the beginning of getting used to people opening doors for me. I so strongly believe in the Lung Life that I want to give back to others with pulmonary condition. I chose to volunteer at Yale Lung Life knowing that I can make a difference in someone's life. When we talk, I understand what they're feeling inside when their oxygen drops below 88. I understand the palpitation, the light headings, and the body weakness and shortness of breath because I have also experienced those same symptoms. I can face the world one day at a time, openly living with oxygen and living an active life. I now know I'm not alone. I am not afraid or embarrassed to walk or to be seen with oxygen. I want to thank Yale New Haven Hospital and say that I am proud to wear the red volunteer shirt. I strongly believe that Yale Lung Life Rehabilitation Program works and can make a difference. I love my work here. I love my work here, which allows me to meet new patients every few weeks as they come and go through the program. I feel confident that most of the patients who finish the program can successfully go out in their comfort zone because they have been given the tools and the knowledge they have gained and earned with us. Lungs, let us now get stronger. It's an activity group that was created in April 2015 by me. I meet new people at Lung Life every 9 weeks. After the 9 weeks are over, some of the friendship can continue and can last for a lifetime. It's an activity group that can help all of us continue to stay active and engaging in activities during the day. As a result of this experience, all of us have greater confidence and comfort with ourselves and our medical conditions. The only prerequisite for joining lungs, let us now get stronger, is to have completed one cycle of Lung Life Rehab programs. Your spouse or partner are welcome to join us. Now that I have just told you when and why reasons of joining lungs, why I created lungs, let me take a few more minutes to tell you why I think it's important to join. Some people have asked me, why do I feel the need to help involve in lungs when I have some personal health issues that I should be focusing on myself? I always tell them, I am taking care of myself. My response to them continues, move to live or sit to die. Are you doing something for yourself? Once again, move to live or sit to die. Alumni is our time to get out and breathe fresh air and have some fun. We joke and catch up with small talks about our family. We also can share with each other's concerns about our health condition. We all have a common frame of reference. We connect like family, and most important, we help each other to keep on going by listening and sharing. Once a month, during those few hours we spend together, we forget about all of our troubles, aches, and pains. We don't focus on breathing. We focus on living and enjoying the joys of friendship. We try to make the trips an educational and fun experience. While we are having a great time sightseeing, we don't realize how much time has gone by. This is a good exercise for the mind, body, and soul. We all feel young and free and even sexy sometimes. This quality makes us some. This camaraderie takes away some of our loneliness and vulnerability. This is nothing that can stop us from breathing life to our fullest. Please feel free to join Lungs. It's a small group right now, but as ants work together to create colonies and cohesion, we can also add members one at a time to create a large group. It's my goal and vision that someday Lungs will be a worldwide group that will raise COPD awareness to all people with COPD and their caregivers. To all my family, friends, and my friends-to-be, I want to share my daily inspirational song. The lyric in this song speaks a powerful and positive message. The song works for me every time, and it lifts up my spirit. Let's take one moment to listen to the song by Whitney Houston, One Moment at a Time, as you see the slideshow. In back of your sheet, you'll have the song. We'll all sing along.
I'm only one, but not alone. Okay.